So far we have discussed the pictograph, bar graph and the double bar graph, and also the pie chart means circle graph, and we have done some problems regarding all these graphical representations. Now let us shift to the topic, chance and probability. So if you take an example in our everyday life, for example, during the rainy season, if you bring the umbrella to the school regularly, it may not rain. On a particular day, if you forget to carry the umbrella to the school, then suddenly it may rain. So this may happen sometime. If you take the another example, like if you go to the railway station in time, so on that particular day the train may come late. So in all these experiments, we cannot decide a result. Well, it may happen or it may not happen. So in all these experiments, we can say that the results have the equal chances of occurring. Now the next topic is getting a result. You might have seen that before a cricket match starts, so then the two captains of the two teams will go out and they will toss a coin. Then they will decide which team has to bat the first. So you are tossing a coin. For example, if you and your friends are playing a cricket match and you have to decide which team has to bat the first, then what you will do? You will toss a coin and then you will decide that you should bat first or your friend should bat first. So if you toss the coin, can you decide which either tail or head comes first? So we cannot decide, because you cannot decide either tail comes or head comes. So the experiment which we cannot decide which outcome will comes, so that is called a random experiment. And here the two possible, either the tail or head, so these two are called outcomes. Here we can consider that the tossing a coin is a random experiment, and in this getting a tail or getting a head, so these two are the possible outcomes in this random experiment. Now consider a wheel. Now what are the possible outcomes in this spinning wheel? So here the outcomes, possible outcomes are A, B and C. And if you consider another example, you have a bag of with 5 identical balls. W means white, R means red, B means blue and G means green, and white, Y means yellow. So out of these 5 identical balls, if you pull out a ball from the bag, so then what are the possible outcomes here? So here also 5 possible outcomes are W, R, B, G and yellow. So these are the 5 balls which are the possible outcomes. Now let us discuss, so what are the equally likely outcomes? Now let us do an experiment. If you toss a coin and several times, then you will notice the possible outcomes occurring in each time. Now for example, if you toss the coin for 50 times, and if you notice that, so the head is as the outcome 27 times and tail is the outcome of 23 times, and if you toss the same coin for 60 times, then we can notice that head is occurring 28 times and the tail is occurring 32 times. Now what is the difference between the number of heads and the number of tails in the first case? So it is 4. And even in the second case, when you toss the coin for 60 times also, the difference is 4. And in the third case, if you toss the coin for 70 times, so then the third case also, the difference between the number of heads and the number of tails is 4. And as you increase the number of tosses more and more, so then the difference between the number of heads and the number of tails will be closer to each other. So here the difference is 4, and here the difference is 2, and in the last case the difference is 2. So the difference will be reduced as you increase the number of tosses more and more. So at some time the difference will be 0, then the number of heads will be equal to the number of tails. So means in this experiment we can observe that the number of heads and the number of tails will be equal. So when you increase the number of tosses more and more, means the chance of occurring heads and tails are equal, means the two possible outcomes, head and tail, so these two outcomes have the equal chances of occurring. So this can also be done by using the die. So if you take a die and throw it on every face, 1 to 6 numbers will be written. So here the possible outcomes are 1 2 3 4 5 6. So if you throw the die for several times and increase the number of times throwing the die, so then we can observe that these all possible outcomes have the equal chances of occurring. So such outcomes are called equally likely outcomes. So here in tossing a coin, the occurring of tail or head, so these both outcomes can be considered as equally likely outcomes. And in throwing a die, the possible outcomes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So these outcomes also can be considered as the equally likely outcomes. Let us see the next topic, linking chances. To probability. Now we will consider an example, tossing a coin. If you toss a coin, then what are the possible outcomes here? Possible outcomes are either head or tail, and these are the two equally likely outcomes, and these two outcomes are also called equally likely outcomes. Because either head come up or T may come up. Now what is the chance of getting head in case of tossing a coin? So now let us write the chance or probability of getting head in case of tossing a coin. Probability of getting head. So this equals to 1 by the total number of possible outcomes are 2. So we can say that 1 by 2 is the chance of getting head. And then what is the chance of getting tail in the same experiment, tossing a coin? Now let us write probability of getting tail. So here also 1, the chance of giving head is 1, and the total number of outcomes are 2. So this equals to 1 by 2. So either the probability of getting head or the probability of getting tail, so both are equal to 1 by 2 in the experiment, means in the random experiment tossing a coin. Now let us take another example. Throwing a die. So when you throw a die, here 1 to 6 numbers are written on each face of the die. So on a on each face 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 numbers will be written. So then what is the probability of getting one? Here the possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and these are equally likely outcomes. So when you throw a die, either 1 can come up, or 2 can come up, or 3, or 4, or 5, or 6. So that is why these 6 possible outcomes are equally likely. So then what is the chance of getting 1? Means what is the chance of coming 1 up in throwing a die? This equals to 1 by the total number of possible outcomes, 6. So we can write 1 by 6. Here 1 is the chance of giving 1 up, and 6 is the total number of outcomes. Then what is the chance of, means probability of coming 5 up? So this equals to, so there is only one chance of coming 5 up. So then 1 by the total number of outcomes are 6. So we can say that 1 by 6 is the chance of coming 5 up. Now let us see the next topic, outcomes as event. Now you already know about outcome of a random experiment. Now let us see what is the event. Now here each outcome are the collection of outcomes. Of an experiment is called an event. So if you take an example, tossing a coin, in the experiment tossing a coin, so what are the possible outcomes? Tail or head. Now what is the probability of getting a tail? So that is 1 by 2. And what is the probability of getting a head? So that is also 1 by 2. Here each outcome, getting a tail or getting a head, is an event of this random experiment. Or if you consider the second experiment as throwing a die, so yeah, the possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here getting 1 or getting 2, getting 3, getting 4, 5 or 6. So getting of each of these possible outcomes is called an event. So here each individual outcome, or sometime we have to take some collection of outcomes. For example, in the same experiment as throwing a die, so the probability of getting an even number. So here this is not an individual outcome. So this is the collection of outcomes, because there are 3 even numbers out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the even numbers are 2, 4, 6. So here 2, 4, 6. So these are the 3 even numbers. So then this equals to probability of getting an even number is 3 by the total number of outcomes, 6. So this equals to 1 by 2. So this is the collection of outcomes. Either 2 can come up, or 4 can come up, or 6 can come up. Now then, what is the probability of getting an odd number? Now the possible odd numbers are 1, 3 and 5. So this equals to, there are 3 odd numbers. So the collection of these 3 possible outcomes, so this is considered as an event. So this equals to, here also we can take that 3 by 6, the number of odd numbers out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is 3 by the total number of outcomes 6. So this equals to 1 by 2. So this is also considered as an event. So yeah, the probability of getting an even number or the probability of getting an odd number, so these two are the events in this random experiment throwing a die. Now let us discuss how the chance and probability are related to real life. Now we can say the two points which are very important of chance and probability related to the real life. So the first one is to find the characteristics of a large group by using a small part of the group. So during the election, an exit poll is taken. So in that case, so they will go to the polling centers and they will take the opinion of the small group of people, because they cannot take the opinions of all the people. So they will take some sample people. So they will choose some people and they will take their opinion. So based on that opinion, and then they will generalize the trend in the election, and they will choose the which party will win the elections. So and the second example is that meteorological department predicts weather by observing trends from the data over many years in the past. So meteorological department, how they will predict the weather? They will take the decisions predicting the weather. So far we have discussed the possible outcomes and equally likely outcomes and the random experiment and the chance and probability related to the real life. Now let us solve some problems. So the first question, list the outcomes you can see in these experiments. In this, the first question is spinning a wheel. So the spinning wheel, in this the outcomes are A, B, C, D, A, but here the possible outcomes are A, B, C and D. So here the possible outcomes are A, B, C and D. Now tossing two coins together. So when you toss a coin, means a single coin, then the possible outcomes are either tail or head. But when you toss two coins, so here I'm taking coin 1 and here coin 2. If you take two coins, either the first coin can give head and the second coin also can give head, or both can give tail, or either the first coin can give head and the second coin tail, or the first coin can give tail and the second coin can give head. So these are the four possible outcomes when you toss two coins together. So either both heads or both tails, or the first coin head and the second coin can give tail, or the first coin tail and the second coin head. So these are the four possible outcomes when you toss two coins together. Let us solve the next question. When a die is thrown, list the outcomes of an event of getting. So when you throw a die, so what are the total possible outcomes? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So these are the six possible outcomes. So out of these six possible outcomes, you have to find out a prime number. So what are the prime numbers of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? We know that 2, 3, 5 are the prime numbers. So in this case, the possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 5. And next, not a prime number. So what are the other numbers than prime numbers? So we can take, because 1 is neither prime nor composite, so we can take 4 and 6. Next, a number greater than 5. So out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so what is the number greater than 5? It is 6. So the possible outcomes is 6. Now, not a prime number. So here 1 is not a prime number. It is neither prime nor composite. So, but according to the question, not a prime number means, so we can take 1, and the other numbers which are not prime are 4 and 6. So here 1, 4 and 6 are the not prime numbers. Now, next question, a number greater than 5. So what are the possible numbers greater than 5 out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? So there is only one possible outcome, that is 6. So your possible outcome is 6. And next, a number not greater than 5. A number not greater than 5 means, we have to write the numbers greater, less than or equal to 5. So your possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So these are the numbers which are not greater than 5. Let us solve the next question. Find the probability of getting ace from a well-shuffled deck of 52 playing cards. So in the well-shuffled deck of 52 playing cards, so there are 4 ace cards. So the number of ace cards equals to 4, and the total number of cards equals to 52. Now the probability of getting ace card equals to the number of ace cards 4 by the total number of outcomes. So means the total number of cards 52. So if we cancel, 4 ones are 4 and 4 ones are 4, 1 is left here, 12, 4 threes are 12. So this equals to 1 by 13. So the probability of getting an ace card from well shuffled deck of 52 playing cards is 1 by 13. Next question, find the probability of getting a red apple. So in the given circle, so how many apples are there totally? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So there are 7 apples. So out of 7 apples, how many red apples are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 red apples. And the total number of apples equals to 7. Now the probability of getting a red apple equals to the number of red apples 4 by the total number of apples, means the total number of outcomes 7. So the probability of getting a red apple is 4 by 7. Okay, we'll solve the next question. When a die is thrown, find the probability of the following events. So the first question is a prime number. So out of the possible outcomes 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, so what are the prime numbers? So we can say that 2, 3, 5. So these three are the prime numbers. Now the probability of getting a prime number equals to the number of outcomes possible by 3 divided by the total number of outcomes 6. So here 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. So this equals to 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 is the probability of getting a prime number. Now, not a prime number. So what is the probability of getting a number which is not a prime number? So the numbers which are not prime numbers are 1, 4 and 6. So these are the three possible outcomes in this experiment. Now the probability of getting a number which is not prime equals to, here also three outcomes are there, so 3 by the total number of outcomes 6. So this equals to 3 ones are 3 and 3 twos are 6 equals to 1 by 2. So here 1 by 2 is the probability of getting a number which is not prime. Now next question, a number greater than 5. So here the possible outcomes are only one number, that is 6. Now the probability of getting a number greater than 5 equals to, so there is only one possibility, 1 by the total number of outcomes 6, so that is 1 by 6. Now a number not greater than 5, so what are the numbers not greater than 5? Means the numbers which are less than 5 are equal to 5, means 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So there are 5 possibilities. Now probability of getting a number which is not greater than 5 equals to, the possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 by the total number of outcomes is 6. So the probability of getting a number which is not greater than 5 is 5 by 6. We will solve the next question. If you have a spinning wheel with 3 green sectors, 1 blue sector and 1 red sector, so what is the probability of getting a green sector and what is the probability of getting a non-blue sector? So in a circle, now 5 sectors are there of equal size. In that 5 sectors, there are 3 green sectors and 1 blue sector and the other red sector. Now we have to find the probability of getting a green sector. So the probability of getting a green sector equals to, so how many green sectors are there? 1, 2, 3. So there are 3 possible green sectors by the total number of sectors, means the total number of outcomes 5. 3 blue, 3 green sectors and 1 blue sector and the other red sector. So there are 5 sectors, so 3 by 5. So 3 by 5 is the probability of getting a green sector. Now let us find the probability of getting a non-blue sector. Probability of getting a non-blue sector equals to, a non-blue sector means, so the other sectors 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 sectors other than blue. So the 4, the possible outcomes 4 by the total number of outcomes 5. So here 4 by 5 is the probability of getting a non-blue sector. Then what is the probability of getting a blue sector? So there is only one blue sector. So we can take that the probability of getting a blue sector is 1 by 5. Then what is the probability of getting a red sector? So there is only one red sector out of 5 sectors. So the probability of getting a red sector is also 1 by 5. So we can write that. Probability of getting a blue sector equals to 1 by 5, and also the probability of getting a red sector also 1 by 5. Let us see the next question. Numbers 1 to 10 are written on 10 separate slips, one number on one slip, kept in a box and mixed well. So one slip is chosen from the box without looking into it. So what is the probability of getting? So there are 10 slips. On each slip, the numbers 1 to 10 are written and they are mixed well, and all the 10 slips are kept in a box. Then if you choose one slip from the box without looking into the box, then what is the probability of getting a number 6, and what is the probability of getting a number less than 6, and what is the probability of getting a number greater than 6, and the probability of getting a one digit number? So let us take the first question. What is the probability of getting a number 6? So we have to get the number 6. So the possible outcomes is only 1, and the total number of outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 10. So there are 10 outcomes. So the probability of getting 6 equals to 1 out of 10. So there is only one possible outcome out of total 10 outcomes. Now the next question, a number less than 6. So what are the possible numbers less than 6? So we can take that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are the 5 possible outcomes when you choose a number which is less than 6. So the probability of getting a number less than 6 equals to the possible outcomes 5 by the total number of outcomes 10. So we can take 5 ones are 5, 5 twos are 10. So this equals to 1 by 2. And the next question, what is the probability of getting a number greater than 6? So what are the possible numbers which are greater than 6? So they are 7, 8, 9, 10. So there are 4 numbers which are greater than 6. So in this 5 numbers are there, but here there are only 4 numbers. So the probability of getting a number greater than 6 equals to, so there are 4 possible outcomes, 4 by the total number of outcomes 10. So you can cancel, 2 2s are 4 and 2 5s are 10. So this equals to 2 by 5. The next question, what is the probability of getting a one digit number? So what are the one digit numbers 1 to 10? So up to 9 all are single digit numbers. So there are 9 one digit numbers from 1 to 10. So here we can take that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these are the possible outcomes of a one digit number. So there are 9 possible outcomes out of 10 outcomes. So probability of getting a one digit number equals to 9 by 10. So then what is the probability of getting a two digit number? How many two digit numbers are there from 1 to 10? So there is only one two digit number, that is 10. So then the probability of getting a two digit number is 1 by 10. So there is only one two digit number out of 10 numbers. So we can take that the probability of getting a two digit number is 1 by 10.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.